chug away at the box office's Last Jedi looms. Los Angeles, to paraphrase Gandalf by way of J.R.R. Tolkien, early December is the box office's deep breath before the plunge. New films are held back as Hollywood waits to capitalize on Christmas. The major studios served up nothing for the second weekend in a row, allowing Coco to remain the top draw at North American theaters. But eight big movies are scheduled to arrive in wide release over an 11-day stretch that starts Friday, when Star Wars: The Last Jedi touches down. Playing in 3,748 theaters, Coco, Disney-Pixar, took in an estimated $18.3 million, for a three-week total of $135.5 million, according to comScore, which compiles box office data. Justice League, Warner Brothers, collected about $9.6 million, for a four-week domestic total of $212.1 million. A not-very-superheroic sum that has Warner rethinking its management of DC Comics films yet again. Third place went to the tearjerker wonder, Lionsgate, which nosed across the $100 million mark in North America by selling about $8.5 million in tickets in its fourth weekend. With backers that include Participant Media and Walden Media, Wonder has connected with audiences in part because of its #ChooseKind promotional campaign. Failing to go anywhere was Just Getting Started, a poorly reviewed comedy released by the upstart film company Broad Green Pictures and starring Morgan Freeman, Rene Russo and Tommy Lee Jones. It cost about $22 million to make and arrived to an estimated $3.2 million in ticket sales at 2,161 locations. Among low-budget Oscar hopefuls, The Disaster Artist, A24, had a very strong weekend, taking in $6.4 million in relatively limited release, 840 theaters, for a two-week total of about $8 million. The Disaster Artist, a well-reviewed movie about a movie, stars James Franco, Dave Franco and Seth Rogen. The darkly comedic I, Tanya arrived in four theaters and collected a solid $245,602. Backed by Neon and 30 West, I, Tanya stars Margot Robbie as the disgraced figure skater Tanya Harding. The Shape of Water, Fox Searchlight, Guillermo del Toro's acclaimed arthouse fantasy, took in $1.1 million in 41 locations, for a two-week total of $1.3 million.